Good morning, students. Welcome to the maths class. How are you all? I hope you all are doing well. In our previous class, we have studied word problems based on number operation. So our today's topic is estimation. What is estimation? Estimation is just the approximated value. Let's just understand the definition. A sensible approximation or guess of the size of quantity, length or weight, etc. is called estimation. It is just the approximation or the guess of anything, any quantity, length or weight. It is called the estimation. Now, we will, in mathematics, we will understand estimating numbers by rounding off to the nearest tens. Let's quickly have a look at this number line. Here it is a number line. Let's consider a First, let's understand it with the help of number line. Then we will read what this paragraph is saying to us. Let us consider a number 14. Now, the gap between 10 and 14 and 14 and 20. By the number line, you can clearly observe that the gap between 10 and 14 is less as compared to the gap between 14 and 20. 10 or 14 ke beech mein gap kam hai as compared to the gap between 14 and 20. So which one is nearest to 14? 10 or 20? Obviously it's 10. So approximated value of 14 is 10. Now let's look at the another example, 16. 16 lies between 10 and 20. Now observe the gap between 10 and 16. And 16 and 20. 10 and 16 and 16 and 20. The gap between 10 and 16 is more as compared to the gap between 16 and 20. So what will be the approximated value of 16? It will be either 10 or 20. Obviously it is 20, as the gap between 16 and 20 is less as compared to the gap between 10 and 16. Now let us consider a number 15. The gap between 10, it also lies between 10 and 20. The gap between 10 and 15 is the same as the gap between 15 and 20. So what will be the approximated value of 15? 10 or 20? Since it lies in between, it is in the center, but we will always take the further value. So the approximated value of 15 is also 20. Now just let me just read this paragraph for you and understand what this paragraph is saying to us. Consider the number 14. We have already considered it in our number line. It lies between 10 and 20. It is clear from the number line. From the number line, we can observe that the gap between the number 14 and 10 is less than the gap between the number 14 and 20. Already explained to you. That is, 14 is nearer to 10 than 20. Thus, the round off value of the number 14 to the nearest 10 is 10. Clear? I have already explained it to you for 16 as well as for 15. But rounding off, always finding the rounded off value or estimated value through number line is not possible. So here is the procedure to round off the number to the nearest tens. For rounding off any number to the nearest step, we have to follow these steps. Let's quickly understand these steps. Step number one. What does it say? Consider the ones digit number of the given number. Any given number, you have to consider its ones digit. We are rounding off to nearest tens, but we have to consider ones digit. If it is less than 5, read it carefully. If it is less than 5, then replace ones digit by 0. Then we have to replace our ones digit by 0, keeping the other digit as they were. And the other digit will remain the same. Ones digit will become 0 and remaining digit will remain the same. Step 3. This was the case when if the ones digit number is less than 5. What if the number is equal to 5 or it is more than 5? Step 3 is the solution. If it is 5 or more than 5, then replace ones digit by 0. In both the cases, we have to replace ones digit by 0. And increase the tens digit by 1. But if it is 5 or more than 5, then we have to increase the tens digit by 1. tens digit by 1. The number obtained after step 2 or step 3 will be the nearest estimated number. Let me just repeat these steps for you. Consider the ones digit of the given number. If it is less than 5, then replace ones digit by 0, keeping the other digit as they were. If it is 5 or more than 5, then replace ones digit by 0 and increase the tens digit by 1. The number obtained after step 2 or 3 will be the nearest estimated value. You will get to understand it more with the help of an example. Let's quickly have a look at the example. Write the estimated number for the following by rounding off to the nearest tens. We have to round off to the tens position. Now, let us consider an example, 293. We have to round it to the nearest tens, but we will consider which digit? Ones digit. We will consider which digit? Ones digit. What is, which digit is at ones place? 3. 3 is less than 5. According to our step 2, if it is less than 5, then replace ones digit by 0. Then we have, instead of 3, we will write 0. Keeping the other digit as they were. And the other digit, that means 2 and 9 will remain like this. Clear? I hope it is clear to you. Since ones digit was less than 5, then we will replace this digit by 0 and the other digit will remain as it is. Clear? Now, let us consider the another example. 56,385. Again, one digit at ones place is 5, which is equal to 5. Now, we will follow our step number 3. If it is 5 or more than 5, then replace ones digit by 0 and increase the tens digit by 1. I have replaced my ones digit by 0, and in place of tens digit, we will increase by 1. That means we are going to add 1 in it. 8 plus 1, 9. Other digits will remain as it is, and ones digit will become 0. Now, quickly have a look at the example. Once again, I hope it's clear to you. This was how to round off to the nearest tens. I hope it is very much clear to you without the use of number line. Now, our next subtopic is procedure to round off a number to the nearest 100. Now, we have to understand in the case of 100. Now, in case of tens, we have considered the ones digit. In case of 100, which digit you will consider? We will consider the tens digit. So, our step 1 is consider the tens digit of the given number. Of any given number, we have to consider the tens digit. Step 2, if it is less than 5, then replace each of the tens and ones digit by 0. If the digit at tens place is less than 5, then we have to replace the ones and the tens digit by 0, keeping the other digits as they were, and the other digit will remain the same. Step 3, if it is 5 or more than 5, then what are we going to do? Then replace each of the tens and ones digit by 0. Tens and ones digit will replace by 0 in any case, and increase the hundreds digit by 1. और वो हंड्रेड्स डिजिट को हम किस से इंक्रीज कर देंगे? उसमें हम सिंपली 1 ऐड कर देंगे. आई होप इट्स क्लियर टू यू. जस्ट रिमेंबर वन थिंग, 100 जब हम राउंड ऑफ करेंगे 100 पोजीशन पे, देन वी आर गोइंग टू कंसीडर द डिजिट एट टेंस प्लेस. और जब हम टेंस प्लेस पे कंसीडर कर रहे थे, तब हमने डिजिट वंस प्लेस की कंसीडर की थी. दैट मींस हम उससे एक कम प्लेस वैल्यू पे डिजिट कंसीडर करेंगे. क्लियर? नाउ लेट्स क्विकली हैव अ लुक एट द एग्जांपल. Write the estimated value of the following number to the nearest 100. हमें किस position पे round off करना बेटा? 100 position पे. Our first part is 95788. Okay? Now we have to round it to 100. We will consider which digit? Digit at tens place. What it is? 8 greater than 5 according to the rule. If it is 5 or more than 5, replace each of the tens and ones digit by 0. I have replaced my tens and ones digit by 0 and increase the hundreds digit by 1. What is the digit at 100 place? 7. 7 plus 1 becomes 8. So our estimated value is 95,800. I hope it's clear to you. Now let's quickly have a look at the another part. 602345. Clear? Now what is the digit at your tens place? 4. Which is less than 5. So we will follow our step 2. Quickly have a look at the step 2. What it is saying? If it is less than 5, replace each of the tens and ones digit by 0, keeping the other digits as they were. That means our ones and tens digit became 0 and other digit, that means 6023, will remain like this. I hope it is also clear to you. Quickly have a look at the example. I hope this example is also clear to you. Now, our next subtopic is rounding off to the nearest 1000. Ab jab hum 1000 pe beta round off karenge, then which digit we are going to consider? Jab humne tens pe round off kiya, then we have considered ones digit. When we have rounded to the nearest 100, then we have considered the tens digit. Now when we are going to round off to the nearest 1000, which digit we will consider? We will consider the hundreds digit. Which digit we will consider? Hundreds digit. And if we are going to round off to the 10,000, then we will consider 1000 digit. Now this we will directly understand with the help of example, because same steps will be followed. 8372. We have to write the estimated value of the following number by rounding off to the nearest 1000. Nearest 1000 pe we have to round off. Now we will consider the 100 digit. Which digit is at 100 place? 3, which is less than 5. When the digit is less than 5, we have to replace the digit by 0. That means our ones, tens and 100 digit will be replaced by 0, and the other digit will remain as it is, since the digit at 100 place is less than 5. That means this 3 zeros and this digit will remain as it is. So our estimated number is 8000. Estimated number is 8000. Now have a look at the another part. 982, and we have to round it to the nearest 1000, but it has 3 digit. We can write it like this. Can we? Yes. Now which digit is at 100 place? 9, which is greater than 5. It is greater than 5. So if the digit is greater than 5, we will replace 1s, 10s and 100 digit by 0. I have already replaced it. And the digit at 1000 place will be increased by which digit has 1000 place? 0. 0 plus 1 is 1. So our estimated number is 1000. I hope it is also clear to you. Quickly have a look at this example once again. Now, moving on to the next example. Write the estimated value of the following number by rounding off to the nearest 10,000. Now the question comes, we have to round it off to the nearest 10,000. Now quickly tell me at which digit we will consider. Since we have to round it to the nearest 10,000, we will consider the digit at 1000's place. We will consider the digit at 1000 place. Now, our first part is 16,526. Now, which digit is at 1000's place? 6. 6 is greater than 5. So, our step 3 will be followed. If the digit is 5 or more than 5, we will replace it by, we will replace 1000, 100, tens and 1 digit by 0, and we will increase the digit at 10,000 place by 1. That means this. We will add 4 zeros and the digit at 10,000 place, that means 1, it will be increased by 1. That means it becomes 1 plus 1, 2. So our estimated number become 20,000. What it become? 20,000. Now quickly have a look at the another part. 25,430. Now tell me the digit at 1000's place. It is 5. Again, step 3 will be followed. If it is 5 or more than 5, these all digits will be replaced by 0. All the digits at the right side will be replaced by 0. So I have replaced it by 0. Since it is 5, so we are going to increase the digit at 10,000 place by 1. That means 2 will be increased by 1. We will add 2 plus 1. It becomes 30,000. It becomes 30,000. I hope estimating by to the nearest 10, 100, 1000 and 10,000 is clear to you. Now, our next subtopic is estimating sum or difference. Now, we have to understand how to estimate the sum or difference. We will directly understand it with the help of example. Example says estimate 4563 plus 2039 plus 7325. Also find the actual sum. You can easily find the actual sum. I have already calculated for you. It comes out to be 13,927. Now question here comes, we have to find the estimated sum as well. But the question here arises, no place is given that we have to round up to the nearest 1000, 100, tens or what. When nothing is mentioned to you, we always round it to the highest place value. We will always round it for the highest place value. All the three digit numbers, all the three numbers are four digit numbers. So we will round it to the nearest 1000. We will round it to the nearest 1000. Now 4563, when we will round it to the nearest 1000, for rounding off to the nearest 1000, we will look at, we will have a look at the 100 place digit. It is 5, more than 5. These all digits at the right will be replaced by 0 and 4 will be increased by 1. This becomes 5000. 2039, it is digit at 100 places 0. That means all digit will become 0 and it will remain as it is. So it becomes 2000. 7325, digit at 100 places 3. So again step 1 will be followed. All the digits at the right will be replaced by 0 and 7 will remain as it is. So we have found the estimated values also, 5000, 2000, 7000. I have written directly because you all have understood it till now, how to find it out the estimated value. Now estimated sum is 5000 plus 2000 plus 7000, which comes out to be 14000, and actual sum is 13920. Thus the actual sum is very close to the estimated sum. Actual sum is close to the estimated sum. Now let's have a look at the another example. Estimate 53999 minus 45712. Already told you in another example, since no position is mentioned at which position we have to round up, we will always round up to the highest place value. Now rounding off to the highest place value, that means 10,000. When we will round off this numeral to the 10,000, what will be the estimated value? Since it is, we will look at the 1000 place digit, 3, no change will take place, all this becomes 0. And since it is 3, step 2 will be followed. So what will be the estimated value? 50,000 again. Now look at this numeral. Digit at 1000 places 5. It is equal to 5. All these digits at the right will be replaced by 0. And it will be increased by 1. 4 plus 1. Again, it becomes 50,000. Now, what will be the estimated difference? 50,000 minus 50,000. Which becomes 0. Now estimated value 0, it is of no value, it is meaningless, it is not possible, it is meaningless. Now since it is meaningless, hum ek approximate value nikale, it is coming out to be 0. That means it is of no value. Now we will round it to the next place value. That means earlier we have rounded to the 10,000, now we will round it off to the nearest 1000, since when we were rounding off to the nearest 1000, our approximated value was coming to be 0. Now, when we will round off to the nearest 10,000, 53,999 will become 54,000 and 45,712 will become 46,000. Now, you can easily find the estimated difference. 54,000 minus 46,000 comes out to be 8,000. I hope estimating sum and difference is clear to you. Our next subtopic is estimating product or question. Now, to estimate the product or question, each number is rounded off to the greatest place. Always remember, to estimate the product or question, each number will be rounded off to the greatest place, as I have told you, while estimating the sum and difference also. Now, note, what does this note says? One digit number is not rounded off. In case of finding the estimating product or question, one digit number is not rounded off. That means if you are given 6, it will not be rounded off. Now, quickly have a look at the example. Let's understand it directly with the help of example. Estimate 97 multiplied by 432. Now, we have to round it off to the greatest place. So 97 will be rounded off to the tens place. Since it is 7 over here, digit at ones place is 7. 9 will be increased by 1. 9 plus 1, 10. And it will be replaced by 0. So estimated value of 97 is 100. And 432, it will be rounded off to the hundreds place. So we will consider the digit at tens place. It is 3 less than 5. This will become 0 and it will be like this. 400. So estimated product is 100 multiplied by 400, which becomes out to be 40,000. I hope this example is clear to you. Now, estimating the question. 475 divided by 71. Now we will round off. Since 475 is a 3-digit number, we will round it off to the nearest 100. For rounding off to the nearest 100, we will consider the digit at 10th place. At 10th place, it is 7. That means more than 5. Step 3 will be followed. If it is 5 or more than 5, replace the right side digits by 0. 7 and 5 become 0, and increase the digit at 100 place by 1. So 4 will be replaced by 1, which becomes out to be 500. Now 71 is a 2-digit number. That means we have to round it off to the nearest tens. So we will consider the digit at 1's place. Since it is 1 less than 5, no change will take place. 1 will become 0 and 10's digit will be like this, 70. Now 500 divided by 70. 0 and 0 got cancelled, which comes out to be 50 divided by 7. When we divided by 50 divided by 7, our remainder come out to be 1 and question comes out to be 7. So our estimated question is 7. Now quickly have a look at this example of estimating the product or question. I hope it's clear to you. Thank you.